So hello guys, welcome back to channel Get to Byte. Today in this video I am going to tell ki what is the logic and explanation behind the working of keypad module and its embedded C code. इसका मैं आपको पूरा logic बताऊंगा कि आप कोई सी भी microcontroller से इसको कैसे interface कर सकते हो और that same logic goes to any microcontroller. You just take a note on the its GPIO registers. And this module is interfaced by using a GPIO peripheral. And for this, I am going to tell you for a 3x4 keypad module. But the understanding the logic and working, 4x4 हो या आपका कोई सा भी keypad module, आप चाहे खुद से push button से बना रहे हो आप अगर अपना keypad, so you can even make code for that also. It's just the logic which you need to understand and the working which should be clear in your mind when you are working on keypad modules and how they operate. So now without wasting time, now let's start our code straight away. As in the last video I have explained its working part. So guys, now I'm going to tell you how to code Arduino keypad, numeric keypad PID 419 with in its low level in via its embedded C code. Okay, so the logic and the things which I'm going to tell you, you can implement those logic and those process to any microcontroller by just having your just taking notes on which DDRC and port registers you are using and keeping them high and low according to our logic and according to our code. Okay, so in this basic thing is like R1, R2, R3, R4 have been connected to the PC0, PC1, PC2, PC3, that is 37, 36, 35, 34 digital IO pins of the Arduino Mega board, and these columns C1, C2, C3 have been connected to 33, 32, 31. The one thing which you need to note is that you just remember that you connect your keypad to the same port, okay? Whether you connect it to PC0 or PL or PB, any port, but they should be connected in a serial order like this, that R1, R2, R3 are connected to first 4 bits of that port and next columns are connected to next 3 bits, 4, 5, 6, okay? So now proceeding to the code, like as I have told in the last video, जो हमारा logic है, जो हम लोग basic thinking रखेंगे keypad को code करने के लिए, कि we are going to set our columns first as input and rows as output. Button is pressed, we will take the value of which column is pre-pressed in the variable. Then I will invert this process, I will make the columns as output, rows as input, and again will take the value of which row is being pressed and then OR it to my column value. So on ORing it, I will get a unique code according to a unique binary number, and then I can map that binary number to the number which I have pressed. Okay, so now this is the basic overview. Now going to the code, okay, line by line. So first of all, I have just declared a key pressed a variable to store my the value of the row or column which I am pressed, binary value. And now first I have set columns as input and rows as output. So columns as input, so PC6, 5, 4 have been set to 0 and PC3, 2, 1, 0 have been set as 1. For the time being, you can ignore this 7th bit, okay? Just don't worry because we have not connected any pin, any keypad pin on it. So we don't have to worry with it. You just can completely nullify, ignore it, okay? And then in the we have set the out column as input, row as output, then port C. Then we are setting कि हम लोग input पे हम लोगों ने pull up resistor activate कर दिया, so that by default our column pins are being always set to high. Now when a button is pressed, then the correspondingly column pin will be set to low. Okay, and rows have been set as output and they have been made to low voltage. So now when no button is pressed, okay, then what will be my default value will be my this one. It is a no button is pressed. Then all the columns which are input have been set to high, so 111. And as the rows which have been set as output have been set as low, so their pincy value on that will be coming to be zero. Now when a column is pressed, let's say C1 is pressed, then this value will get changed to 111 and 5 times 0. If C2 is pressed, then 11 01 4 times 0. C3 is pressed, then correspondingly its value is changed. So when a button is pressed, then it will come out of the while loop and its value will be saved on the key pressed variable. Now as I have noted, I have stored the value when button is pressed and column as input. Okay, now I am reverting the process. Column I have been set as output, row as input. So now columns have been set as output. So these bits 111 and rows as input. So these pane have been last four pane, first four panes have been set to zero. Okay, delay microseconds 1. These delays are very important. You just don't ignore them. Okay, because these actually like make our program a little bit in a structured manner. They make our pin change the when we press a button, the change which occurs because of these delays, all things are synchronized properly. Okay, then now I've set columns as output, rows as input. Output pins will be set to low, so columns have been set to zero, and input pins will be set to high by activating their pull-up resistor. Now in this also, when no button is pressed, their default value will be this one. Okay, why this one? As these column pins have been set to output and low, so these column pins are low. Row, these have been set to as input, and pull-up resistor high is activated. That means value 1, so these are 1. Okay, now let's say if R1 is pressed, then its value will be this one. If R2, R3, R4, and whatever the button we have pressed, when we press a button, both R1 and C1 will be changed. Okay, because like I have told in the last video that when we press a button, it is the R both C1 and R1 get short-circuited. Okay, so now here first I have made the row column as input, now row as input. So row as input, so its value will be correspondingly this. Now I have OR the value of my when call or in the value of row and column when pressed, they are set as input respectively. So the row is when set as input, its value is being OR with the column value when it has been set as input. Okay, now I have set the switch case, switch key pressed. Now if the R1 C1 column, you remember in the last video, so it will be C1 will be this one, R1 will be this one, as I have stated this here. Okay, so ORing this value, I will get this value. So if this value comes of the key pressed, then return 1, that is 1 is pressed. Similarly, if C2 R2, that means two second button. So if C2 is as input, column 2 as input, and its button is pressed, then this will be the value, its binary value on pin C. And correspondingly R1 also, when it is set as input, its pin C value is this. ORing these two both values, we will get this one. So return 2. So same logic I have done for all these 12 keypads. Star 0 hashtag C, when hashtag is present, C3 R4, 0 C2 R4. So correspondingly C2 is value and R4 value when they are pressed as input. Okay, they pin C value. Okay, so now and I am returning all the integer which I have pressed and then break the statement so that it comes out of the switch case. So in the main loop, I have done simple thing. You just ignore this one. I have initialized UART communication. UART a variable to store the return value which I have pressed on the keypad. A equals to get key and then simply printing on the display screen. Okay, so let me just quickly build this code. Okay, and then just upload it. Okay, so now it is uploaded and now let's connect. Okay, so now let me just connect it. Okay, and now when I press a button 1 on keypad, so button 3, then it shows 3, 2, 1, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 star 0 hashtag. So this is how you can interface your keypad module to any microcontroller, whether it's 8-bit or 32-bit, by just keep remembering this logic that first its column pins will be set as output, input rows as output, take down their value on the pin C register, that is on the any GPIO, the microcontroller if you are using, then it's equivalent to pin C register. Then store its value on the key press, revert the process, column as output, row as input. Delay, just take a note on this delay also because they are very important. If you will not place this delay now, then it might happen that when you very quickly type the buttons now, then it may miss out some keypad's value. Okay, store the when you have reverted the process or the value with the column value which you have stored on the key press, and then just use the normal switch case. Now if you have used अब कोई से और पोर्ट्स पे यूज कर रहे हो, या आप R1 R3 को मान लो लास्ट के 4 बिट्स पे सेट कर रहे हो, एंड C1 C2 C3 हैव बीन सेट टू एज फर्स्ट 4 बिट्स, या इनका चेंज करो, सो जस्ट मेक अ ड्राई टू अ ड्राई रन लाइक आई हैव डन इन द लास्ट वीडियो, जैसे मैंने आपको समझाया था, उसके अकॉर्डिंगली करना कि क्या-क्या मेरे कॉम्बिनेशंस होंगे स्विच केस के अंदर और ये व्हाइल लूप के अंदर कंडीशन. ओके, सो गाइस दिस इज हाउ यू कैन इंटरफेस योर कीपैड मॉड्यूल. ऑल द कीपैड मॉड्यूल्स आर बेस्ड ऑन द जीपीआईयू पेरिफेरल ओनली. वी सिंपली जस्ट सेट आवर पिन्स एज आउटपुट एंड इनपुट एंड सेट देम हाई और लो. सो आई होप यू लाइक द वीडियो एंड गेट टू नो अब हाउ पावरफुल अ माइक्रो कंट्रोलर इज, हाउ पावरफुल एम्बेडेड सी एंड जीपीआईयू पेरिफेरल इज, दैट इट कैन कंट्रोल योर कीपैड मॉड्यूल्स, योर all the keypad modules which you see on the ATM also, they are based on this process only. Okay, so that's it for now. जैसे कि अब हम लोगों को इसके में थोड़े एप्लीकेशंस बताऊं तो इंडस्ट्री में होता है कि हम लोगों को सर्वो मोटर कंट्रोल करनी है, स्टेपर मोटर कंट्रोल करनी है इन सीएनसी मशीन्स या इन ऑटोमेटिक वायर कटिंग मशीन्स, तो उसमें हमें इनपुट डालना होता है. ओके, न्यूमेरिक इनपुट कि डेट आई वांट 30 डिग्री एंगल और 30.5 और 16 और 120 एनीथिंग. सो दिस इज वेयर योर कीपैड मॉड्यूल विल बी यूज्ड. आप सो दैट्स इट फॉर नाउ. लाइक द वीडियो, सब्सक्राइब द चैनल एंड press the bell icon to get notified for new videos and share it with your friends.